In this After Effects tutorial, I'll show you how to create and animate this infinite loop. Hi guys, my name is Manuel. So we're gonna create and animate this infinity symbol. Infinite infinity, with just a few shape layers. So, no time to waste, let's start. As always, we need a new comp. Name it infinite loop, 24 frames per second, 72 frames long. Then we choose the ellipse tool, double click on it to create a new shape. Of course we label it. Let's name the layer road. We open the path property, deselect constraint proportions, and set the size to 500 by 500 pixels. No fill, stroke color orange, stroke width 90 pixels. We right-click on the path and convert it to a bezier path. Then we select the upper and lower point and move them to the center. Next, we rotate the right point 180 degrees while holding shift and adjust the shape until it kind of looks like the infinity symbol. It doesn't have to be perfect. Awesome! We duplicate ellipse 1 and set the bottom stroke width to around 106 pixels. And set the stroke color to red, to get a border. Then we link the upper path to the bottom one, using the property pick whip. We duplicate the ellipse one more time, set the stroke width to 2 pixels, and change the color to white. We open the stroke property and add dashes and gaps. It kinda looks like a road now. We duplicate the layer, name the new one Shade, and move it below. In Contents, we delete ellipse 3 and 2. We link the path of ellipse 1 to ellipse 1 of the road shape. Why is that? You'll see at the end. And we set the stroke color of the remaining ellipse to a dark purple. Then, we use the Effects and Presets window to add CC Bandit. Place the start on the right side, the end on the left, and take care nothing is cut off. Then we bend it slightly, minus 5 degrees maybe, so the road seems higher up on the left side. Next, we need to work on the part here where the road crosses. Let's add a bridge. We duplicate the road layer and name it Bridge. Then we add Trim Paths to the Contents property. Where is it? Okay, which means all shapes are affected by it. Let's solo the layer, we adjust the start and end point until the crossing part is left over. Then we quickly link the three path properties to the ellipse one path in the road layer. That looks good. Now we need something to move along the path, right? We duplicate the bridge layer and name it ball. And delete ellipse 3 and 1. Let's change the stroke color to green. We set the stroke width of ellipse 2 to around 72 pixels. Let's open trim paths and set the start to 99.9%, the end to 100%. In stroke, we set line cap to round cap, and we have a point, or ball. Then we simply animate the offset. Oh, but let's actually add a drop shadow first. We change the shadow color to a dark blue. Distance 14 maybe. And let's adjust the direction. We set an offset keyframe at the beginning and simply add a 1 at 65 frames, which means 360 degrees one round. The speed right now is linear, so let's work on that. We open the graph editor and edit the speed graph. Downhill fast, and then slowing down when going up again. That's what we want. And the two points need to be at the same height. Let's check it out. All right, not bad. Then, let's change the length of the object. We set a start keyframe at the beginning. Set it to 98% around 14 frames. So it's longer when it's really fast. Then back to a circle, 99.9% at around 30 frames. Again, we adjust the speed curves in the graph editor. Slow down the beginning and the end of the animation. Awesome. Now we need to make sure the ball rolls through under the bridge. We duplicate the bridge layer, move it above the ball layer. Change the stroke color to white and use it as Luma inverted mask for the ball. Now there's one thing left to do. After the ball passed the bridge, we split the two layers and disable the track mat for the second half. Let's add a null object. Link all layers to it and rotate this whole thing 3 degrees. Awesome. If you still want to change the path shape, remember we linked all paths to the ellipse one path in the road layer. So if we change that, we change it all over. Very convenient, right? On the left side of edits and videos you might like, subscribe to my channel on the right side and hit the bell, cause you don't want to miss my next video. Thanks for watching this one. See you in the next one. Bye guys.